If you're thinking about becoming involved in clinical research as a patient representative, you may have concerns about the commitment needed or the amount of time the research might take. It's useful to remember that different roles will vary in how much or how little is expected from you. In this film, Richard, Dave, and Ben talk about the practicalities of their involvement in different aspects of clinical research.
The amount of time it takes to be on the PRC varies from week to week and month to month. The key really is how many trial proposals come up and that you're asked to look at. It does take at least half a day to do justice to a trial proposal, and in my case it takes half a day just to read through it at least twice, often three or four times. I'm very fortunate when I come to meetings here in London because I live close to London. So you have the nice and simple train journey and then the meeting itself. The length of the meeting I find really hard to predict. Sometimes it looks like a really simple idea and a really simple trial should be over with in an hour, but you're there all afternoon. And sometimes something very complicated can actually be broken down into something simple because everyone's agreed on broad principles and suddenly you're only looking at fine detail. So it's very hard to tell, but a meeting will usually be at least an hour to talk about even the most straightforward trial where there is nothing to add, because people want to make sure that the design is absolutely as good as it can be and that the information going to patients is absolutely as good as it can be.
In the early stages, we were meeting two or three times a year. But as the trials become more advanced now, it's probably something like 80% recruited the patients that it needs for the answer. We have less meetings now. But I still see the trial management group every year, at least once a year. And I'm obviously in touch with them by telephone and by email. And so if there are any issues that they need to run by me, they know they can get in touch.
There are several meetings a year, and of course, particularly at the early stage when we're talking about trial protocols and how the trial is going to be designed and run, there's a lot of reading to be done and more meetings at that stage. Then once the trial is recruited and up and running, hopefully it all ticks along unless there's a glitch or a problem. And then again at the end there'll be a burst of more activity because that's when the results are being written up and there'll be more to read and to comment on at that stage.
Patients and patient representatives contribute significant time and energy to our clinical research. To recognise this, it's our policy to pay our patient representatives, and we also make sure that their expenses are reimbursed or wherever possible paid for in advance.
I receive my travelling expenses and any out-of-pocket expenses for doing my work for the MRC CTU, and I also receive a small allowance or honorarium. So there is, I suppose one would call it payment for services, but that's certainly not the way I look at it, and I don't think any other patient rep would look at it that way either. We receive recompense for our time and our energy and our commitment.